Melatonin. Apparently, it's not just for sleep anymore. Now, it could be viewed as an eye health supplement. A recent study just published in JAMA Ophthalmology assessed for the use of melatonin supplements on both the development and the progression of age-related macular degeneration. And this was not a small study. This was a retrospective cohort of over 121,000 patients. And what they found was pretty impressive to say the least, showing that for patients aged 50 to 70 years old who took the melatonin had about a 65% decreased risk of developing or getting the disease. Like, yes, please. And then they also reported up to about a 62% decreased risk of progression for those of people who had already been diagnosed with the more mild early dry macular degeneration. And honestly, this is pretty impressive. These are some great looking numbers. Okay, so why? How can this be? How can melatonin, a sleep hormone and supplement, help prevent and slow down a disease within the eye? And how much melatonin would somebody have to take in order to gain this protective effect? Now, we've covered macular degeneration in some previous videos here on the channel, and I'll put some links in the description below if you want to check those out. But in short, age-related macular degeneration is an eye condition that affects people over the age of 50, resulting in blurred or diminished central vision due to a deterioration of the inner retinal layers of the macula. The macula is the central bullseye area within the retina in the back of the eye that is responsible for giving us clear, focused vision in your direct line of sight. This can often affect your ability to read small letters, your ability to see the road while driving, and even recognize faces of family and friends, those sort of things. Macular degeneration is also the number one leading cause of permanent legal blindness for older age adults. So if we can do anything to slow it down and prevent it, it's a big deal. Okay, so why might melatonin help with this type of retinal disease? Most people probably know of melatonin as a sleeping hormone or supplement that they can take to help them relax before going to bed, as in many countries, like here in the United States, melatonin can be purchased over the counter for just this purpose. It turns out that within the eye, melatonin has been shown to have a very potent antioxidant effect and helps with the health of the mitochondria within the retinal cells and within a layer of the back of the eye called the retinal pigment epithelium, which sort of works as a scaffolding supportive structure for the retinal cells. And this protective effect is essential because both oxidative stress and mitochondrial damage play key pivotal roles in both the development and progression of macular degeneration. And in addition to this, melatonin has also been shown to help regulate inflammatory cytokines, which are inflammatory cells that contribute to more of the advanced cases of macular degeneration, including the development of new blood vessels within the eye, as well as scar formation in the cases of wet macular degeneration, as well as the development of geographic atrophy, which are sort of retinal dead zones that we see in more of the severe end-stage cases of dry macular degeneration. Again, if you're not super familiar with the differences between dry and wet macular degeneration, I have done a previous video on that, and if you want to know more, I will put a link to that in the video description below for you. Okay, so how much melatonin does someone need to take in order to gain this protective effect and reduce their chances of macular degeneration? Well, unfortunately, this study did not select for or report on dosages, which is a huge letdown of the study, I think. But I did dig a little bit deeper and found another study from 2005. This study looked at patients with macular degeneration and treated them with 3 milligrams of melatonin every night. And of the 55 patients who returned for follow-up visits at 6 months, showed no changes in visual acuity at that time and even had reduced pathological changes to their retinal health during their retinal evaluations. And in addition to this study, there are several other publications of using oral melatonin as a treatment for another retinal condition called central serous chorioretinopathy, and those studies report no significant side effects. Okay, now before anybody runs off and starts taking melatonin as a supplement specifically for this reason, it's important to understand that the general accepted guideline is to always take the most minimal effective dose. And taking more of a supplement does not necessarily confer greater health benefits. It's also important to understand that melatonin can interact with other medications and other supplements, And there is a general concern amongst both healthcare providers and researchers that taking melatonin as a supplement could alter your brain's own endogenous development of melatonin, because your brain does make melatonin on its own. With that being said, there is currently no real concrete evidence that the brain does this, but still it's a concern that doctors and researchers have. But either way, while yes, this research study is largely positive, I don't expect that any retina specialists or other eye doctors are going to be recommending patients to start taking melatonin for this purpose, at least until we have some more robust studies available. Things that look deeper into exact mechanisms as well as safety and dosages. Those things are really important before I think the general kind of practicing health community is going to be accepting it and recommending it. I think it's important that for anybody who plans to take melatonin, even though it's available over the counter, to talk to your family care provider, your primary care provider, and any sort of eye doctors that you see so that they're aware that you're taking it, why you're taking it, and just in case there's any interactions with medications or other things going on. Now, interestingly enough, sleep is a hot topic in research right now around eye and healthcare. And so there are benefits that are going beyond just retinal health for macular degeneration and diabetes, but also for conditions like dry eye disease. So to stay up to date on all of that type of information as more research comes out, definitely subscribe to the channel so you don't miss those future videos. Otherwise, if you're interested in learning more about specific nutrients or supplements that are ideal for the health of the eye and vision, then check out our video that we did here up to the side. Or if you want to learn more about macular degeneration, we also did a live stream on that subject, and you can learn more about that clicking down over here. Otherwise, Dr. Allen here, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a fantastic day.